We found out yesterday that Kyrie Irving doesn't like Boston, wanted to go to Brooklyn. Cool. We found out yesterday that your man's Kevin Durant wanted to join Kyrie at Brooklyn. And these are two chump moves. These are two chump moves by all-star players, one of which is actually one of the greatest of all time, but he's still a chump. He's not a chump because he left Oklahoma City. He's not a chump because he decided to leave Golden State. He's a chump because he kept talking about how much he wanted his legacy to be defined by him being able to do something by himself. And what did he do but join another beta with Brooklyn? And we're talking about a dude that ain't going to actually be able to play basketball for a year, who's getting paid $164 million over 4 years, and Kyrie's getting 4 years, $141 million, so that they could, quote-unquote, play together. Well, first of all, y'all can't play together for 12 months, so pump the brakes on that. But you got two betas on a Nets team that I was really excited about because I thought they were building them the right way. Even they have rehabilitated D'Angelo Russell to the point of a max deal with Golden State and a sign-and-trade. I wouldn't have paid max money to know D'Angelo Russell, but I understand the move. Now, outside of Kyrie and Kevin Durant both being betas, and I do believe you got to have an alpha to win championships, and neither one of those dudes likes giving up the rock, I'm here for this train wreck because I am a league pass junkie. The NBA gets my money because I love watching it late at night, and I got some league pass teams I'm already excited about. I'm one of these dudes that watches Summer League way too closely while Wimbledon is also on. That's who I am. But I'm also concerned about Oklahoma City because Oklahoma City seemingly picked up Mike Muscala. Mike Muscala is a forward slash center, and I get it, right? You needed that dude because Steven Adams is on the block. It's days before that dude's get traded. But you picked up Muscala, and you thought you picked up Nerlens Noel in free agency after he opted out, rightfully so. Now, the Muscala move makes a lot of sense because he made $5 million last year, and that's going to be $20 million less than Steven Adams is getting paid this year. And you need to get under the salary cap or under the luxury tax. We'll talk about the salary cap in a minute. And in Muscala, you got that stretch five that you want. Career 36.5% shooter from beyond the parabola. So there's your shooting five that you got straight out of Dollar General at 11th and 169. I can't fault that move. But now, you thought you was going to get Nerlens Noel. So did Woj, right? Woj busted the news. And then we got Nerlens Noel dropping question marks on his Instagram story. Like, wait a second, I'm doing what? Since when? For what? For how? And then you got Woj tweeting, oh, okay, so it seems Nerlens has backed out of talking about what he's going to do and wants to take some time to reevaluate. Yeah, he want to reevaluate how much Billy Donovan liked playing him in the first place, and he want to reevaluate how Billy Donovan treated Enes Kanter, who just busted up Oklahoma City. When we talk about Billy Donovan, we don't talk much about how he treats his centers and how he actually needs a Steven Adams type dude out there because he likes Steven Adams. I'd also, if I was Nerlens Noel, I'd want scary money to do for me what he did for your man's Muscala, which I'll get to in a minute. But I would also want to talk over with scared money. How come you think that I'm going to take the mid-level exception for 5.7 after watching 33-year-old Al Horford get 4 years, $109 million from Philly? You think that's what I'm about to do? And because I know you signed a center with offensive prowess like you had Kanter last year, and Nerlens was a reason your defense was so good, maybe Nerlens wants to be thought of as a starter playing more than 13.7 minutes per game behind a dude that was just another dude in the Melo Schroeder trade. Or maybe he wants to be recruited like you recruited Muscala. Presti flew up to Muscala's house in Minnesota to go get for what many folks was just another dude to put in a trade. And you think that what? Nerlens Noel's going to just take this mid-level exception you want to give him out of his good graces? No. I wouldn't do that because we live in a world where everybody's going to make loot in the NBA that's halfway worth the doggone. The vet minimum is over $1 million, okay? The loot is going to be there. What's not going to be there is, do you love me? Do you love me? Because that's where I want to take this conversation. When we talk about free agency, we do not talk about it in terms of love and attraction, okay? Attraction is ridiculous. It's happenstance. It is completely inexplicable. You get attracted to who you get attracted to for reasons that don't actually fall into common sense until after the fact. And by after the fact, you do some moving and shaking around. You do that courtship stuff. And then you figure out whether or not you love this person by getting to know them. And love is a choice. Most of what y'all think love is actually BS. But love is not magic. It is a decision. It is good. It is healthy. It's deliberate. It's an external effort and energy every single day. It's choosing and committing. It's doing. There is a banner up in the studio that says Oklahoma, then it has a heart, then it has thunder. People here chose to love the thunder. Did Preston choose to love Nerlens Noel? Or did he choose to chase attraction and dude named Mike Muscala? Okay? When we talk about the free agents moving around, Brooklyn doesn't know if they love Kevin Durant. They don't know if they love Kyrie Irving. You know who does know they love him? Boston. Boston wanted to love that dude. And we had Kyrie Irving like 8 months ago talking about, I'll resign if you'll have me in October. Attraction. You 20 minutes old in Boston. You don't know if you like this. Found out you don't like this. And now we're talking about, ooh, Jimmy Butler to Miami. That's a sexy move. Ooh, D'Angelo Russell to Golden State. That's a sexy move. Ooh, Kawhi Leonard could end up with the Lakers. That's a sexy move. Yeah, I keep saying sexy and how that ain't usually how people describe marriage. They describe marriage as commitment. They describe marriage as that's my homie. That's my best friend. That's my down partner. Somebody that you are attracted to is not who you're going to call for bail money. That's just not what it is. Okay? You meet Susie Floozy on the street. And you say, what's up? I like that sundress you got on. It's hot. And then you get locked up. Guess who you not calling? You not calling Susie Floozy. You calling your mama. You calling the woman that's going to put up the house to come get you out. If you meet your homeboy on the street, that's your bruh. And then because that's your bruh, you're going to help him move that couch. Okay, like, I would never want to be John Wick with that coin. That's why I have a truck and I don't help you move. You're not going to John Wick me with that coin. Mm-mm. Because, like, if I help you move, that means I own you. That means when I show up to your house, like Keanu Reeves showing up at Halle Berry's house with this coin, you're going to do what I tell you. Because that's what it means to be of the contract of love. So, while free agency is sexy and it's attractive and it's really, really good on your skin. It's like a nice hot shower. What you need to be looking at is the person that's doing the dirty dishes next to you. What you need to be looking at is the person who was changing them stank diapers from your toddler. What you need to be looking at is the person who says, you know what, baby, you stay there, you lay down. I'm going to go get up. I'm going to put Bray back to sleep. I'm going to pat her on the back. You know, we're going to go for a ride at 3 a.m. in the morning so she go back down. That's what you need to be looking at. You know who we don't hear going out here free agency doing stuff? The Spurs. You know who's always making the playoff? The Spurs. You know who put together championship squads when it was their window? The Spurs. And when Presti took this job, it was supposed to be San Antonio North. And everybody was on board for that. Because small market energy and whatnot. But that's just not what it's been. Because all of a sudden you're chasing luxury tax dudes like Dion Waiters. Never going to forgive you for that. Talking about, no, we trade James Harden for the good of the franchise. Okay, where you at now? You signing Mike Muscala and you having to ship Steven Adams off. And you talking about trying to get Nerlens Noel back because you didn't treat him right in the first place. Nerlens know what time it is. It's time the rest of us did too. Stick with the one that you love. I'm going to go after this attraction nonsense.